to purchase your first house, you'll purchase your first property, no matter you are residential or investment. So this is very fair. In the future, there are more coming, more new rules and new guidelines are coming. So you have to take note about that. So it definitely will affect your cash flow. So from government, our Kementerian Kewangan, what they are implied the most, this part is most affected the investor as well. Real property gain tax. Does anyone doesn't know about this? So actually this will be implied some sort of a tax percentage when you gain from your selling of properties. So from here you have to pay certain tax. So if let's say I buy a house 2 years ago, now I want to sell it, I have to pay 30% of what I gain from the selling price to the government. I pay the tax. So this 30% will affect what? It will affect the selling price even higher. So actually this 30% will transfer to you because you are the buyers. The seller is a very smart one. They will imply all sorts of causes to you. So that's why that there is a more properties right now, especially the second hand market, the house value is higher and higher due to these factors. And in 2013, actually, there are many speculators of the real property. They are quickly sold off their houses due to this percentage. Okay, extra information GST will be coming. So definitely, for the investor, it may be gain less. That's why they have to mark up the selling price. End up, the buyers will suffer because they have to pay more. You see. And the selling price, the net selling price, all coming so you harder to get the bank loan, all these things. Then you have to fork out more cash, more deposit for it. So some regulation, you have to understand the background. What is the market right now when you going to start a real estate investment? Just now I say the law part, actually many fresh buyers, they are annoyed because then normally developer will about it. But just now I said, no more DIBS, no more freebies, then actually you have to bear of it. So this factor, actually I will advise, no matter you are residential, you are only one house, or you will be an investor, I will advise you that to get your own lawyers, because it's very logical sense that the law, if you hire your own lawyer, the lawyer will cite you, right? Will give you benefit. If you use the lawyer for developer, then the lawyer will cite the developer, right? If you follow the banker, follow the lawyer will cite the bank, right? Because the bank is the boss. So it's very fair sense, right? So sometimes I will normally advise my client to get the own lawyer. At least the lawyer will help him, especially the second-hand house market. It's very important because you will see coming, there are more restrictions during the transpiration. If there is booming not, there are many restrictions there. And even MP consent, I have a client that applies the house based on because for this MP consent, MP is a Menteri Besar, the state authorities. There are some restrictions there of the title. It takes about 3 to 4 months to wait the government to approve it when you transfer the titles. So there are more legal shops actually you never heard before. And some property limitation, even Malaysia, the one Malaysia house, there are some rules, regulation also that you cannot sell this house, you cannot sell this house within 10 years. You have to hold it for 10 years. There are some conditions there. Even some house, are they title available or not? Are there certificate of fit available or not? This also actually will affect your house to delay your time to get to own your house, means to stay and get the key. So actually all these legal things will waste time. Time is money, actually it's wasting the money as well. And you know that when you apply a loan, when you sign over, when you get agreement, actually the legal time, there is a legal time there. If you exceed the legal time, when you actually you say you release the money to the seller or to the house owner, the existing one, you will incur interest penalty charges to you. So you have to pay more. So actually legal part is very important, but I will not say the details here, just a brief introduction. So from here, your property investment, you have to understand there are many key factors. These are the main parties that are involved in real estate investment. But then we know that government, Bank Negara, bank, legal rules and guidelines, can we control? Can we change it? Say, I don't want the house sell so high, you quickly help me to reduce it, then I can buy. Can you do that? No. So actually, yes, these factors we can't control. What you can control is yourself. So I will touch on this part. As a buyer or investor, these factors are very, very important when you're going to start your investment. Okay. So a person, a standard financial planning pyramid will be like this. So there are many very detailed parts from here. So if you see that the house ownership actually is here in the middle of the pyramid. So house, no matter you are for residential, actually it is wealth accumulation part. It means that actually your house is not your protection. So what this pyramid say that is that if let's say you have something, accident or uneven event happen, this bottom part will be disturbed. So what means that will be disturbed? The cash flow, you doesn't have the income, your expenses is increased, and you have to keep going to pay your debt, your credit problems, and your risk problems, then your this part, the bottom, you just ruin, and your whole pyramid, the upper part will be collapsed. So this is what I'm main focus in today's presentation. So, and for the bank side, actually, they are most looking at this part, the debt. Do you have the ability or affordability to return payment, because they are lending you money, right? So they have to make sure that whether they can receive back this money with interest. If not, then the economic crisis will come. It's like 2007 happened. Okay. So in Malay, in the world, our healthy income distribution actually will be like this percentage. Means that our income comes in. We have to distribute our income to this part. So actually, that if you want to, let's say like a healthy financial, let's say I don't want here like I don't have money to use, I'm not enough money, I buy a house already, then after that I no other money to travel, I cannot wait, I cannot marry, I cannot do something because I have a car, I have a house. This is what means from this chart. If your debt portion, all debts include credit card loans, car loans, housing loans, dividend loans, whatever loans, you can control by 30%, then this is your fixed expenses, then you're able to save the portion. This saving portion is for your future, the you of future, in the future, the retirement part. And this specific plan is for your, maybe your wedding plan, your if couple, there will be housing short-term plan, your mortgage down payment plan, education, travel, whatever, we so-called short-term plan. So then you can have a healthy financial portion. So you will less suffer from the trouble. But in reality, this is many people that cannot do. Many people that do this chart, that the debt that cover many parts. And the fixed expenses and the savings comes later. That's why they get trouble from the cash flow. In Malaysia, there's just the latest November last year, the news said average every week of 60 people get bankruptcy in Malaysia. It is increasing. So you can just see from that, from the statistics, almost 50% from the bankruptcy people, they get trouble from car loan and housing loan. the rest are just a small portion. So I'm looking into like, what happened to these people? Because they don't have a very good debt management and as well as cash flow. And we look at it. Now we have a trend, become younger and younger. 25 to 45 this age group. More than 50% of the bankruptcy people. This real statistic from the Insolvency Department Malaysia. So it has to be looked into seriously in this portion. So now we come back to what is it related to real estate property investment, real estate investment. So from the bank's perspective, when we go in to apply, just now I said the bank will look at the debt portion. So we call it DSR, debt servicing ratio. This is the bank when you want to apply, they will look at these factors. Your property valuation, your loan to value ratio, and your risk profile. So I won't go into because it's very complicated, I would say. Just simply say that property valuation, what does it mean? Just like I say, market, let's say the market value of the house, second hand house, the market value should be 300,000. But right now the market selling at 400,000 means that there are 100,000 difference of the house. Bank you not bear. Bank will follow the 300,000 for loan. So means that you have to borrow you have to fork out your 100% your 100,000 deposit cash if you want to buy the house. This is the main thing. So from here, as just now I said, this one you cannot control, but you can control here. Because this will show your cash flow and your affordability to the bank. So in Malaysia, we have a guideline that the bank will calculate your debt portion from your net income is 60% and gross income is 50%. What does it mean? So example, age 25 youngsters. So her gross income is 3,000 monthly. So if this person, she doesn't have any liabilities, means that no car loan, no credit card loan, whatever loan. So you minus all this EBF and SOSO, balance will be this net income, and we calculate 60% from here. Then the maximum installment for the red part will be about 1,005. Then you're able to apply the loan for apply the house loan for maximum this amount. But what are the different that, let's say, now you are still very like to buy a car first. It definitely will be harder because lower your installment and you can apply higher house value. So that's why many youngsters, they doesn't know, and I got friends that they very like this house in Penang, they pay the down payment already. About 30,000 plus, but then because the market value too high, you cannot get the loan. You cannot fork out the extra cash as well. So at the end, it creates more problems, more troubles that you have to refund, you have to get back down payment, you have to talk to your seller, I cannot get, and so on. Luckily, you didn't sign any agreement. If you sign any agreement, sorry, the legal action is stuck. Means that the down is completed. So when you get a purchase, I will seriously advise that better check your cash flow, your affordability before sign any agreement, legal agreement, means that so-called loan agreement or sales purchase agreement. Because once you sign, the legal action is done. As just now I said, legal action is very troublesome. Okay, so this is the bank's perspective. Any other risks that you think about? Any more? Okay, when you get a bank loan agreement, as I said, I already successfully to get a loan agreement from bank, so very happily I get a house. Okay, so normally the bank loan agreement will take about 3 months normally, with 3 months to process and release the money to the seller or developers. So within these 3 months, actually you haven't started any repayment yet, right? But although you haven't paid anything yet besides down payment, this house, is it considered yours? Do you think? I haven't paid anything yet. actually is yours, because just like I said, loan agreement is signed, means that legal action is yours already. You just take time to process the legal action. So what happened is that during these 3 months, although I haven't started paying my installment, anything happened? What do you think? Like accident? We have a client that is a construction worker, get a house, get a bank loan, settle everything. Then during this 3 months processing period, after give back the offer letter to the bank, after 1 month, because he's doing construction work, he fell down from 10th floor and accidentally passed away. So when the wife, she's a housewife, she goes to the bank, say, my husband passed away, so how about the bank? How about my house? Because it's in his name. So I remember I heard my husband say he got buy the mortgage insurance. It means that I don't need to pay anything, or what happened. The bank check, say that, oh, the documentation haven't submitted yet, so you cannot pay. Means that you have to continue paying. But there is a trouble is that the husband actually paid the premium during that he signed the offer, just that because of the neglection of the banker staff, during this 1 month they didn't pass out the documentation to the insurance company. There is a neglection of the bankers. So end up, our teammates, our colleagues able to help him to claim back the insurance thing and release the house, the wife only to pay a single cent besides the down payment. So you see that this is very important even though you haven't started any installment. This is a real case. And even some case, I have some clients that a businessman, he buy a lot of cars and properties, but then he accidentally passed away also. Then the wife, so the housewife, they go to the bank and check. Oh no, all the properties, all the assets, they're under her name, not the husband's name. So, do you see the trouble? I don't need to say it anymore, right? So it's very important and you have to look it clearly, look it seriously on this portion. And even critical illnesses, you cannot work. So this is definitely will affect your properties and your investment. And it will create your debt. If you cannot manage well, it will create your debt to your family, to your beloved person.